Hey everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today I'm going to talk about my favorite steroid that I take daily and one that I suggest you take as well, whether you're man or woman. Now this steroid is extremely powerful in improving your health while also reducing different diseases and different forms of cancer by as much as 50%. Now some of the benefits of the steroid is it increases and improves fertility in both men and women. It helps build stronger bones and reduces hip fractures by up to 75%. It dramatically improves your immune system, so it helps reduce colds and flus. It reduces depression and improves your mood. It helps with weight loss by also reducing your appetite and cravings. It improves brain function, memory, and reduces Alzheimer's diseases. It helps reduce inflammation. It improves your blood sugar levels and has many more benefits. Now, as far as the cancer, it helps reduce breast cancer by up to 50%. Liver cancer by 33%, prostate cancer also by 50%, colon cancer between 25 to 35%, and skin cancer by 20 to 40%. All right, so obviously this steroid has many benefits, and the best part is that it's very safe, even in higher doses. So this is why I suggest you should take it. And the name of this steroid is calcitriol, also known as vitamin D. Now, technically speaking, the term vitamin D is actually a misnomer. It's not a true vitamin because the human body has the capacity to synthesize its own calciferol, except in rare instances of complete lack of ultraviolet radiation, which means that the best way and place to get your vitamin D is outside from the sun. Now, the problem is that the dermatologists have ruined things by constantly telling people to wear a ton of SPF and sunscreen and how the sun is so bad for you and causes cancer. Yes, going outside or to the beach for a few hours at a time when you're super white and getting burned is bad for your skin. But listen, we all need at least 20 to 30 minutes daily of direct sunlight on our body, preferably year round. And the problem is that these days, you know, we're either indoors all the time or when we do go outside, we're just completely covered up, you know, with clothing and hats and, of course, toxic sunscreen. This is why most people are deficient in vitamin D. And by most people, I mean at least 80 to 90%. And if they are within that quote unquote normal range, they're usually on the low end of the range, which isn't very good. You want to have higher levels of vitamin D. I suggest at least 50 nanograms per milliliter, and I like to keep mine personally between 80 to 90 on the higher end of the spectrum. Now, doing a simple blood test will tell you where your levels are. And as I stated, 90% of people have low levels. They're basically deficient or have insufficient amounts. And to fix this, I suggest you just get outside daily and get some sun on your skin. And the best time to actually do this is first thing in the morning. It actually helps improve your circadian rhythm. Now, if you're worried about wrinkles, wear a hat and cover your face and neck, you know, where the wrinkles matter. Now, if this isn't possible for you to get outside, which it probably isn't for most of us, then I suggest you take extra vitamin D3 daily. I recommend at least 5,000 units. Take it again first thing in the morning with food. I personally take 10,000 units or more higher levels during the winter months. So do yourself a favor and make sure you get some extra vitamin D. You'll look and feel much better, which will also help reduce illnesses, diseases, and cancers. Also, please do me a big favor and let me know what topics you'd like me to cover in my future videos. I have a special link below in the description area that you can fill it out and it'll go directly to my private email box. This helps me make videos that you want to watch about the topics that you're interested in. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.